Happy New Year and welcome to your January 2022 horoscope. My name is Kaylin and today I'm going to be covering the major transits for the month ahead using tropical astrology and the whole sign system. I strongly recommend that you watch your horoscope for your ascendant, sun and moon sign, but having said that, I would start with your ascendant sign if you're only going to watch one today. Now, before I get into your reading, I just wanted to let you know that my 2022 yearly horoscopes are available for purchase. So you can purchase your individual horoscope using the link in the description box below. Once again, I would recommend that you watch for your ascendant, sun, and moon sign, but if you're only going to purchase one, I would start with your ascendant sign. So these horoscopes are about an hour and a half in length, but you can also purchase the 12 pack, which is over 18 hours of footage. And now let's dive into your horoscope. Hi Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Risings. Welcome to your January 2022 horoscope. Before I get into your reading today, I just wanted to pull an animal spirit totem card to see what energies will be with you for the month ahead. Okay. So we've got the zebra. Oh my God, I love this card. So this is all about you displaying your eccentricities and embracing what makes you unique and different. Obviously, zebras are part of the horse family. So, you know, with their stripes, this shows that there's going to be something about you this month which really stands out from the crowd, no matter how much you try to hide it. So you may as well embrace it. But now let's get into your horoscope. On the 19th of December, we saw Venus station retrograde in the sign of Capricorn in your fifth house. The reason I'm mentioning it in your January horoscope is because it will be retrograde in your fifth house until the 29th/30th of January, depending where you live in the world. So essentially, your romantic life, your creative gifts and talents, and your business, if you own your own business, will be a very big area of focus for you, as will your children, if you have children or if you are trying to conceive. Now, on the 29th of December, we will see Jupiter enter the sign of Pisces. So this means that Jupiter will be transiting your seventh house, which represents your one-on-one relationships. And it will be in your seventh house until the 10th of May in 2022, at which point it will enter Aries. Now, Jupiter will retrograde from Aries in your 8th house back into Pisces at the end of October, where we'll spend 2 months until right before Christmas being in your 7th house. So in a nutshell, you will have Jupiter in your 7th house for 6 months of the year. With Jupiter in your 7th house, this indicates that you may meet a romantic partner. So this could be someone who is a Sagittarius or a Pisces, as indicated by Jupiter ruling over these signs. Or this individual could be a musician, a travel agent, they could be involved in the tourism industry in some way, or they could be an artist, as indicated by Pisces, or perhaps they're a teacher, a counselor, or even a lawyer. Now, with Jupiter in your seventh house, you may be getting married this year between those periods of time which I mentioned, which once again will be the first 4 months of 2022 and pretty much November and almost all of December at the end of the year. Now, for those of you who are in a committed relationship, your significant other could have something really positive that happens to them during these periods of time. Now, they could go through a big transformation on a spiritual level, so you may find that they are becoming more spiritual or that they are more interested in things like astrology and tarot and literally anything occult or spiritual in nature, or they could have a huge win in their career and really come into the limelight for something. On a more physical level, your partner may be putting on a bit of weight during this period of time. Now, on a different level, with Jupiter ruling over your fourth house as well as your seventh house, some of you may be increasing your investment portfolio when it comes to the property market. Now, this can see you having a big demand on your time and on your services. And I'm saying this because Jupiter is opposing your Virgo sun, moon, or rising. So obviously every time we have Jupiter transits, we always get excited, but when it is an opposition or a square, this can actually put a fair bit of pressure and tension on you. Now, if you are a Virgo moon like myself, this can see there being a lot of pressure on you from your family or from people that you live with, or this could be with regard to your responsibilities around the home. If your sun is in Virgo, this can see there being a lot of pressure on you when it comes to your career, or perhaps there is someone who is pushing you to expand and basically step outside of your comfort zone when it comes to your career and your life goals. If you are a Virgo ascendant or rising, all of the above can apply to you. Now on the 2nd/3rd of January, depending where you live in the world, we're going to see a new supermoon take place in Capricorn at 12 degrees in your fifth house. Now, this new moon will actually be in a wide conjunction with Venus, which will be at 22 degrees Capricorn, and of course Venus will still be retrograde, and also we're going to have Pluto at 25 degrees Capricorn. Now of course we always need to look at what the ruler of the moon is doing. So in this instance we're going to see the new moon in Capricorn making an exact semi-sextile to Saturn in Aquarius in your sixth house. And we're also going to have our ruling planet Mercury being at 0 degrees Aquarius in your sixth house. So I actually see this as being a very auspicious new moon, and that is because it involves your ruling planet, and of course we're having this positive aspect being made from the ruler of the moon to the supermoon. So this indicates that whatever is starting for you around this period of time, it will have some kind of longevity to it, or there will be a very solid foundation to it. Now, because this new moon is taking place in your fifth house, on one level, this can see there being a new romance taking place. Now, because Venus is retrograde, I believe that this will be someone who you have already tried to initiate a relationship with. So maybe you've been on and off with this person, maybe they haven't wanted to commit to you, maybe there's been some issues with long distance travel, and that is because Venus rules over your ninth house, and maybe you are forming this relationship with this person and they're still living abroad. In some way, shape or form, if a new romance is starting, there's likely to be some kind of deep, intimate connection with this person, and that is thanks to this conjunction with Pluto. Now, for those of you who own your own business, this can see there being some kind of new expansion of this business. And I'm saying this because the fifth house represents owning your own business, and we've got this semi-sextile to Saturn, so this indicates that there will be some kind of grounding force which takes place within this business. So maybe you got off to a rocky start, maybe you didn't have the finances or the resources initially, and now there's a solid foundation to it which allows it to flourish. And I'm saying this because Venus rules over your second house, which is Libra, and like I said, Venus is retrograde. So maybe you are now receiving the funds to support this new business or starting up this new service or launching a new product. And of course, for those of you who've tried to launch this business before, this can see you having some kind of relaunch with regard to this business. Now, some of you may actually be falling pregnant around this time. And I'm saying this because the fifth house rules over children. And of course, we've got Pluto involved here. And Pluto can indicate the birth or a conception taking place. Now, we've also got Jupiter in Pisces opposing you. So the fact that we have your fifth house being activated, Pluto being activated, and Jupiter making an aspect to you just spells out that this may be the case for you. Now, for those of you who are falling pregnant around this time, I would say that it's more likely to be you Virgo risings or those of you who have your moon in Virgo. And this would especially be the case if you are a Virgo moon or rising at 12 degrees. Now, another way that this new moon in your fifth house can play out is that you may just discover some kind of new talent or creative gift that you have, and maybe you were completely unaware of this. Because this new moon will be in a wide conjunction to Pluto, which rules over your third house of skills and talents, maybe this is something to do with the occult, so let's say astrology, tarot, numerology, or maybe you were discovering that you have a natural gift when it comes to things like psychology and counseling. Now, on the 14th of January, we are going to see your ruling planet Mercury stationing retrograde at 10 degrees in Aquarius. So this will be in your sixth house. The sixth house is all about your daily habits, your health, and of course, it represents your work and your duties and responsibilities. So with Mercury being retrograde here, you may have some work projects that you need to revisit. Perhaps you thought that a certain work project was complete and now your boss is saying, no, you need to go back and do this again. Or if you work for yourself, maybe you're going to be restructuring your systems and processes when it comes to how efficient you are being on a day-to-day basis. Mercury rules over these things anyway, and of course, being your ruling planet and ruling over your 10th house, this really just highlights that work will be taking up a lot of your attention and focus for pretty much most of January, especially because we always have a 2-week post-shadow period. Now, with the sixth house ruling over health, some of you may be revisiting a health practitioner, whether this is a doctor or anyone who deals with health or works in the health industry, or this could actually be a nutritionist as well. This would just be, you know, you seeing the same person again. Mercury retrogrades are not about seeing someone new. They're about revisiting something that we've already done before or engaging the services of someone that we have employed before. Now, this could actually see you re-entering the workforce. So if you have been out of the work game for a long time and you've been struggling to re-enter the workforce, you may have a lot of success with this respect during January, and especially between the 14th of January and the 25th of January. Now, on a different level, this can see you quitting your job, especially if this is a decision that you have been putting off. Mercury retrograde periods are not necessarily about taking big action, but if it's something that you have been putting off or that you have delayed doing or that you've tried doing over and over again, you can have a lot of success while Mercury is retrograde. And just so you guys know, I actually launched my own business during a Mercury retrograde period, and you know, I'm pretty happy with where things are at. So do not let retrograde periods deter you from taking important action, especially if it's something that you have been thinking about doing for ages. Now, on the 17th/18th of January, we are going to have a full moon in Cancer take place at 27 degrees in your 11th house. Now, this full moon in Cancer will be in almost exact opposition to Pluto, and we're also going to have Venus being retrograde at 13 degrees Capricorn. So we're obviously going to have the Sun, Pluto, and Venus all in your fifth house. So essentially, full moons indicate the ending of a chapter taking place, or at the very least, they indicate a situation reaching its peak. Now, because this is occurring in your 11th house and the moon is the ruler of Cancer, I see this as you guys, and hopefully me as well, achieving some kind of long-term goal or dream or finishing some kind of project. And this is because the 11th house is connected to our long-term goals and dreams. And of course, with Venus being in your fifth house as well as Pluto, and the fifth house representing your creative gifts and talents, hopefully you guys are successfully completing some kind of creative project or an artistic endeavor, or there could be some kind of huge win that takes place with owning your own business. Some of you may actually be launching your business during this period of time. Now, this can actually see you receiving some kind of big payout, and this is because Venus rules over your second house, which represents your finances and resources. And of course, Pluto represents large amounts of money, and the 11th house is already considered to be a money house anyway. The 11th house in astrology represents residual income or passive income. So perhaps you are receiving some kind of payout when it comes to dividends and investment, royalties, maybe rent money for a property that you own, or this could even be an increase in your salary. Now, the 11th house represents our social media platform. So maybe you will be achieving some kind of goal that you have when it comes to your social media platform or accounts, and what you wanted to achieve in terms of maybe subscribers, followers, Or this could be more about you being able to reach a larger audience and helping them in some way, shape, or form. And this is because the 11th house is connected to our socioeconomic goals. So perhaps you want to be helping a large group or a large community. And of course, the 11th house is connected to large groups and communities anyway. So with this full moon in your 11th house, you may actually be calling it quits when it comes to a friendship circle, or you may actually be leaving some kind of group or a community that you've been part of for a very long time. And the zebra is catching my attention here, and it just makes me think that maybe some of you feel like your values are no longer in alignment with these individuals. And this is indicated, astrologically speaking, by the fact that Venus rules over your second house in Libra, and it's retrograde. And the second house is connected to our values. So maybe you are realizing that you don't have the same goals anymore as your friends or as people that you've been working with in these communities or in these groups. Lastly, though, this could actually see you healing your relationship with a friend or even with a sibling. And I'm saying this because Cancer has a very healing energy, and this opposition to Pluto, which rules over your third house of friendships and siblings, indicates to me that you may be putting things to bed and basically just realizing that it's water under the bridge and it's really not conducive to your own long-term goals and dreams for you to keep revisiting these negative attachments or these negative situations that you experienced with a family member or with a friend. Now, also on the 18th of January, we are going to see the North Node entering the sign of Taurus in your ninth house. And of course, the South Node is going to enter Scorpio in your third house. So the last time that we saw the North Node and the South Node in Taurus and Scorpio respectively was 19 years ago. And they will be transiting your ninth and your third houses for 18 months until the middle of July in 2023. The North Node transiting your ninth house is very, very positive. And that is because it will be trining you as a Virgo sun, moon, or rising. And with the North Node being in an earth sign, this is basically just really positive for earth signs across the board. Now, with the North Node in your ninth house, this can see you becoming very hopeful for the future or very ambitious about your long-term goals and dreams. Now, this can see you actually discovering some kind of new intuitive ability or even a psychic ability. And that is because the ninth house is connected with prophecy and seeing the bigger picture. Now, the ninth house represents our belief systems, and the North Node, otherwise known as Rahu, can indicate that you are going to be having some pretty wild and wacky beliefs. So this could be your beliefs surrounding things like astrology, spirituality, aliens, are they real, are they not, space travel, the truth about space, and of course the ninth house represents higher forces and higher powers. So this indicates your ability to connect to a faith, or basically represents your ability to connect to source or spirit or God or whatever you want to call it. Now, the ninth house represents belief systems of all kinds, and the North Node, well, Rahu, represents something scandalous. So you may actually come into the spotlight for some kind of outrageous belief that you are talking about or discussing or posting about. And for some of you, this could be those aforementioned things that I just said, so astrology, aliens, space, etc. But for others of you, if you were formerly very spiritual or if you were formerly very religious, this could see you becoming an atheist. And maybe this is like shocking the people that you used to be in a community with. And the same can be said for if you were well known for being an atheist. So for example, Ricky Gervais comes to mind. Maybe you're going to be shocking people because you are suddenly spiritual or suddenly religious. Now, the ninth house is also connected to education, travel, and the law. And Rahu, or the North Node, can represent new technology and something which is artificial or futuristic. So maybe you are going to be discovering some kind of new technology surrounding travel, or you may be introducing some new form of tourism or something new to the tourism industry. And of course, the North Node is associated with import and export. So maybe you are looking at entering into the import and export trade, and this could be with some kind of new technology, which people find to be quite progressive, or it could even be quite scandalous. Now, on a different level, with the North Node in your ninth house, this could see you becoming quite obsessed with your world beliefs. Now, when I say world beliefs, it doesn't just have to be religious, spiritual, or being an atheist. This could be your political beliefs or your beliefs about how the world actually works. So you could actually become quite well known for these strange beliefs or these progressive beliefs, and you could become very obsessed and fixated with these beliefs. So, you know, when I say obsessed and fixated, this is because Rahu in astrology has a very insatiable quality to it. So it's sort of like, no matter how many videos you watch on YouTube about astrology or spirituality or God or conspiracy theories, it will never be enough. So you can really go down a rabbit hole with being obsessed with these beliefs and discovering more and more information. Now, with the South Node being in Scorpio in your third house, this can see you letting go of friendships that you no longer want to be involved with. And this is because the South Node, otherwise known as Ketu, dissolves things. So this can cut both ways. On one hand, there may be people that you're friends with who you just can't be bothered with anymore, or you haven't really known how to exit these relationships. But on the other hand, this can see you falling out with people who you really didn't want to lose touch with. Now, on a positive note, the third house represents your perspective, and with Scorpio representing something which is toxic and the South Node dissolving things, if you formerly had a very pessimistic and negative way of seeing the world or of communicating with other people, this can see you taking on a more spiritual demeanor, and essentially your negative perspective or your sense of pessimism may simply dissipate over the course of this 18-month period. Now, on a positive note, this can see you finishing some kind of apprenticeship or a course or a project, or you may be mastering a certain skill or talent. Now, the danger with having the South Node in the third house is being overly perfectionistic when it comes to certain skills or talents. And some of you may find it hard to concentrate and focus, and that is because the South Node, otherwise known as Ketu in astrology, can carry a sense of confusion with it, and worst case scenario, apathy. So this can see you becoming quite apathetic towards your friendships or your relationships with colleagues or with teammates. And certainly if there were projects that you're working on or courses that you were pursuing, this may see you just not really caring about these anymore, or basically finding it difficult to concentrate. Just remember though that this is a general reading, so this will apply to all of you in very different ways. Now, lastly for the month, on the 24th of January, we are going to see Mars enter the sign of Capricorn, which means it will be transiting your fifth house. Now, there's going to be a lot of activity in your fifth house right at the end of January, and that is because on the 25th, we're going to see Mercury, your ruling planet, retrograding from Aquarius in your sixth house back into Capricorn in your fifth house, and Venus will be retrograde in Capricorn in your fifth house until the 29th/30th of January. So I want you guys to carve out the last week of January to just deal with things that may come up with regard to your romantic partner, your children, and of course owning your own business. And if you have some kind of creative hobby or project that you've been working on, you may just need to put a lot of attention on these matters. I don't want you guys to freak out though when I say that you'll need to focus on your children, because it doesn't have to be negative. This can basically just be that your children want to spend more time with you, or they need your help with something, and the same can be said for your romantic partner. In any case, Virgo, that's all I have for you for January 2022. If you want to see more content and you don't want to wait till next month, you can actually buy my 2022 yearly horoscope, and you can do so by clicking on the link in the description box below. Of course, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more content on this channel, please hit the subscribe button. Enjoy your month ahead, and I will see you guys next time.